I want to piss off my Chinese friend. What the heck is this? Hello everyone, welcome back to ShuoShuo Chinese, ShuoShuo 中文. I'm Shuo, your native Chinese speaking teacher living in Bangkok, Thailand. I know the resultative compliment sounds a little bit too formal or maybe a little bit boring for you, but if you finish today's video and truly understand it, you will understand a big and important part of Chinese grammar, which will be so helpful not only for organizing what you have learned before, but also for your future study. So, what is the resultative compliment? Well, it has something to do with the essential rule that I have mentioned in many of my videos. I call it the essential rule to make it a little bit easier to refer to. But deep inside, if I could put all my feelings into one name, I want to name it the universal ultimate golden super fantastic rule. And I also explain it in detail in my structure review plan course, SERP. Talking about the structure review plan course, I guess you will be interested in this 21 days challenge. Here is what you should do. Step 1, purchase the structure review plan course through the link in the description down below. From today to April 15th, the price after discount is only $27. Probably even less than a dinner, but it can help you build a clearer understanding about the Chinese sentence structure and the system. Step 2, finish all the 10 lessons within 21 days. And step 3, post a short review on Instagram or Facebook. Don't forget to tag ShuoShuo_Chinese on Instagram or ShuoShuoChinese on Facebook. You can also contact me directly through WeChat or email if you don't have an Instagram or Facebook account. And I will contact you and send you the final test. Students who finish the final test with 90% correctness can get the full price refund of the course fee. So basically, you can get my course for free and motivate yourself to truly improve your Chinese sentence structure within 21 days. So make sure you check the detailed rules of the 21 days challenge in the description box, and you can also click the link there to see more information about the structure review plan course. Okay, back to the essential rule. Basically, it has two parts. If A describes B, A comes before B. And if A is the result of B, A comes after B. I explained the first part in this video and this video. And today's video, the resultative complement has something to do with the second part. If A is the result of B, A comes after B. So we use a verb to show someone is doing an action, like 想, 说, 看, 洗, or even 住. And sometimes we will add something after the verb to show the result of the action. And this part sometimes is just one character, and sometimes it's a word or a phrase. It's called the resultative complement. For example, 听 means to listen, and it only describes the action. But if you add a 见 after the 听, 听见 means to hear. It includes both the action, 听 to listen, and 见 receiving the sound. I listened and I received the sound. 听见 means I hear. This is to say the verb itself only tells you the action. And one action could have different results. For example, 看, 看见, 看到, 看, 看完, 看, 看懂, 看, 看错.
Hey! Oh, 对不起, 我看错了.
笑, 笑出来. 写, 写对. Actually, you can find some similar phrases in English, like to put down, to find out, to save up. Most of the situations, you can easily tell the meaning of the phrase from the verbs and the resultative complements, while some other situations might not be as clear. For example, the resultative complement 找 which shows the result that someone successfully touched something. For example, 摸着够着找着 and 睡着 My mind successfully touched the world of somnolence. Number two, 住 is a special resultative complement that indicates something is not moving anymore.
接住接住啦
嘿没接住
or 记住 The memory or the knowledge is already in my brain and won't move out anymore. Number three, 下去 keep doing something from now. For example, 跑下去 as in我一定要坚持跑下去。我一定要坚持跑下去。胖下去。我不想再这样胖下去了。我不想再这样胖下去了。起来。Besides showing a result of getting up, like 坐起来 or 站起来,起来 can also show the result that an action has started and will be continuing. For example, 雨下起来了。雨下起来了。他笑起来了。他笑起来了。他们打起来了。他们打起来了。Now let's put these phrases into sentences.
我看懂了这个中国电影，但是有一些地方我还没听懂。这些包子你可以吃，但是不要吃完。这个字你写错了，我也没写对。
As shown in the examples, the structure of resultative complement sentences is...Verb plus a resultative complement plus 了 or 没有 plus verb plus resultative complement. Actually, the resultative complement structure itself is really easy and really common in Chinese language. If you still feel good now, shall we continue? Let's continue. Now I want to show you two other situations where you can apply the resultative complement structure. The first one is used in the 把 sentences. If you have watched this video, you will know that the structure of 把 sentences is subject, 把, object, verb, and something here. So this part is where we can put the resultative complement.
我把衣服洗干净了。我把衣服洗干净了。我把他的名字写错了。我把他的名字写错了。
Sometimes the complements can be longer than just a single word.
请把你的名字写在这里，请把你的名字写在这里。他还没有把钱还给我。他还没有把钱还给我。别忘了把穿过的衣服放到篮子里去。别忘了把穿过的衣服放到篮子里去。
You can also put the resultative complement in this structure. This structure shows whether a certain result can be achieved or not. If the result can be achieved, you can say verb, the resultative complement. If not, say verb, 不 resultative complement. For example,
这个包子太大了，我吃不完。这个包子太大了，我吃不完。我找不到我的手机了。 我找不到我的手机了。我觉得这个问题我解释得清楚。我觉得这个问题我解释得清楚。
Then what is the difference between 吃完了 and 吃得完?
Good question. The basic resultative complement structure simply show whether or not the result has been achieved. While the verb 的 resultative complement structure means that someone does have the ability to make the result happen. But it doesn't mention whether the result has already happened or not. And the verb不 resultative complement shows that someone doesn't have the ability to make the result happen.
这个面包我还没吃完，但是我吃得完。
我以为我吃不完，但是我吃完了。
你看，你看我写的是什么？
我没看清楚，我再看一下。
哎，你看，你看那里写的什么？
我没戴眼镜，看不清楚。At the end of this video, let's recap a little bit. So the basic structure is a verb plus resultative complement. If you do an action, it could have different results, which can be shown by the complement. Most of the complements can be easily understood, but there are some specific words like 住、着、下去、起来 needs to be memorized. If the result has happened, you say verb, resultative complement, and 了. If it hasn't happened, you say 没有 verb, resultative complement, without 了. There are other two main situations where you can apply the resultative complement structure. The first one is 把 sentence, and the structure is subject, 把, object, verb,resultative complement. The second structure is verb 的 resultative complement or verb 不 resultative complement, resultative complement, which shows whether or not a certain result can be achieved. So I hope this video can help you truly understand the resultative complement. I'm so sick of saying this in this video. And if you're still watching, leave a heart emoji in the comments. Let me know you finished watching this video. Because I always wonder how many people can truly finish the Chinese studying video or just clicking and switch to a cat video or a 考研网站的 video. So these are all the content of this video. Make sure you check the description box to see the 21 days challenge of the Structure Review Plan course. Hit the like button if you think the video is helpful and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and turn on the notification bell so you won't miss out the great chance to improve your Chinese. I'm Shuo from Shuoshuo Chinese. I will see you in my next video. 再见!